Hello guys, welcome back. Let's see one of the C language question which was asked in GATE 2015. Consider the following two C code segments. Y and X are 1 and 2 dimensional arrays of size n and n by n respectively. Means Y is a 1 single dimensional array and X is 1 2 dimensional array, they are saying. Where that n range is between 2 and 10. Assume that in both code segments, I mean this is code segment 1 and code segment, in both code segments, element of Y are initialized to 0. Mean whatever the elements are there in Y array, those all elements are initialized to 0, and each element xi of j of array X is initialized to I plus j. Means let's take a 2-dimensional array with size something like, let us take 3 by 3. That means n by n means where n is 3. 3 by 3 means it will be matrix is in the form 0 starts with 0 1 2 row number starts with 0 1 2. Okay, let's take this Y array also a single dimensional array which size is 3, right? N value it is also 3. 3 means it is going to store 3 elements, 0, 1, 2, and they are saying that Y elements are all initialized to 0. I have initialized to 0. And each element xi of j of array X are initialized to I plus j. Means this, let us take this is I and this is j. So this one I will call it as x0 of 0. This one I will call it as x1 of 0. This one I will call it as x0 of 2. What I am saying is, let us take like this, I by j. See guys, matrix representation is like this, x, I by j. I represents total number of rows and j represents columns. Don't get confused. So first I need to take rows and then column. Means here I am going to represent like x0 of 0, x0 1, x0 2. I mean this is 0 comma 0, this is 0 comma 1, 0 comma 2, 1 comma 0, 1 comma 1, 1 comma 2, 2 comma 0, 2 comma 1, 2 comma 2. That is what we know, right? So they are saying that the values present in the 2-dimensional array are sum of I plus j in the corresponding position. This is 0, 1, 2. This is I, right? And this is j. This is what? 0, 0. I plus j is 0. This and 0, 1. I plus j is 1. I plus j is 2. J plus I plus j. Here 1. I plus j, 1 plus 1, 2. I plus j, 1 plus 2, 3. 2 plus 0, 2. 2 plus 1, 3. 2 plus 2, 4. That is what they are saying. Initialize it to I plus j. So 0th row, 0th column, 0. 0th row, first column, 0 plus 1, 1. 0th row, second column, 0 plus 2, 2. Like this we have taken. So these are the elements of the 2-dimensional array, that is X. Further, assume that when stored in main memory, all elements of X are in same main memory of the page frame. That is what they have given. Okay. Let's take code segment. Initialized elements of Y to 0. Yes, we have already read. Initialize elements of x of I of j of x to I plus j. That is we already did here. Now they have given on for loop. For I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus 1, I plus plus, y of I plus equal to x of 0 plus 0 I. Means we can rewrite like this one. Y of I equal to y of I plus x of 0 of I. 0 of I means I value initially 0, y of 0 is 0, this 0, and x of 0 of 0, x of 0 of 0 is 0. 0 plus 0 you will get this 0, this 0. 0 plus 0 you will get 0 in the location y of 0. Now I value will be 1. So y of 1 equal to y of 1 plus x of 1 of x of 0 of 1. y of 1 is what? 0 plus x of 0 1. X of 0 1 is 1. 0 plus 1 1. 1 will be replaced with y of 1. That is 1. Next, I value will be incremented to 2. Y of 2 equal to y of 2 plus x of 0 2. Y of 2 value is what? 0 plus x of 0 2. 0 2 is 2. 0 plus 2 2, that will be substituted in the y of 2. So answers are 0 1 2. Next, I value will be incremented to 3, but 3 less than n value is 3. Condition fails, so it comes out of the block. So code segment 1 is completed. So after the code segment 1 completed, the values are 0, 1, 2. Next, let us take code segment 2. They have taken like same as it is with the values 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 2. This is y. Next, x of I of j of x to I plus j. This is what we did. Next, for I equal to 0, I less than an I plus plus, y of I equal to same, y of I equal to y of I plus x of I of 0. Okay, let's take I value as 0. Then it is y of 0 equal to y of 0. I'm rewriting here. Y of I equal to y of I plus x of I of 0. Okay, let's take I value 0. Then y of 0 equal to y of 0 plus x of 0 of 0. Y of 0 is what? 0 plus x of 0 0 is 0. So 0 plus 0 is 0. That will be updated in the y of 0. Y of 0 already 0, so 0. Next, I value will be 1. Yes, 1 less than 3. Condition true, then y of 1. I mean, here you will get 1. 1. X of 1 of I. Y of 1 is what? 0. 0 plus x of 1 of 0. X of 1 0 means 1 0. You will get the value 1. 0 plus 1, 1. That will be updated here. Next, I value will be 2. Y of 2 equal to y of 2 plus x of 2i. Y of 2 is what? 0. 0 plus x of 2 of 0. X of 2 of 0 means second row, first column. X of 2 of 0 is 2. 2 plus 0 is 2. That will be updated here. Y of 2. Next, I will be 3. 3 less than 3. Condition fail. It will come out of the block. It comes out of the block. Now, in the code segment 1, my final result is an array with 0, 1, 2. In the second segment after execution, result is 0, 1, 2. Now, they are asking that which one of the following statements is correct. Final contents of array Y will be same in both code segment. Yes, right? This is Y code segment. In Y code, in Y array, I got the value 0, 1, 2. In the second code segment, Y values are 0, 1, 2. Yes. So final contents of both segments are same. Yes, condition is true. Next, they are saying that elements of array X accessed inside the for loop are shown in the code segment 1 are continuous in main memory. They are saying that the elements which are present in the for loop, which we are using in the code segment 1, are present in the continuous memory. So to make answer to this one, you need to understand. You know, every two-dimensional arrays is going to store in the form of, in our system, either in the form of row measure order or column measure order. C language programs are going to store in the form of column measure order, row measure order. Okay, fine. Here, what they are doing is they are trying to take the values continuously. Means first they are taking x00, x01, x02, like this they are taking. So the elements which are present in the array are continuous memory. So it is, they are going to store in the form of continuous memory. So option 2 is also correct. But coming to the S3 statement, the code segment 2 are continuous in memory. But here if you take this one, if you analyze, here you will get x00, first one is okay. Second one is x10, third one is x20. If you want to understand more clearly, I will explain. let's see this array representation in our system. If we trying to store in row measure order format, then first it is going to store continuously all rows first. I mean 0 0th row, then 0th row first column, second column, 0th row third column. This is first row. Then second row 10 11 12, then third row 20 21 22. If it is trying to store in a column measure order, it will be some different. First 00 10 20 means first this column will complete, then 01 11 21, then 02 12 22, like this it is going to store. Okay, if you take the second statement S2, in S2 how we are going to access x00, x01, x02, x03, like that means 00, 01, 02, like this are accessing, means 00, 01, 02. These are all present in the continuous memory. Main memory, in main memory, these all reside as a continuous. So that is what they said. So option 2 is correct. But when we move for S3, while accessing for loop, the code segment 2 are continuous in main memory. But how they are accessing? 00, 10, 20. 00 is at one location, 20 is if it is column measure order, okay. The 00, 10, 20, if it is column measure order, okay. But if you take our C language is going to store in the form of row measure order. In row measure order, 00, okay. 10 is at after two addresses, it is going to store. What about 20? After two addresses, it is going to store. Okay, I hope you understood. C language will follow only row measure order. So row measure order, if you take the second for loop, 00 is at this location. After two memory locations, 10. After two memory locations, 20. So these are all not continuous, but they are saying that these are continuous in memory. So option S3 is wrong. So S1 and S2 are correct. So which one is option is the, that is correct. So option C is correct answer. I hope you understood clearly. Thank you.